Hello friends, how are you all? Hope you are doing great at various aspects of your lives. Dr. Vineet Agarwal studied science and pursued his career in the medical field. But the stories he heard from elders while growing up always kept him fascinated for literature, especially mythology. Eventually, he decided to rewrite this mythology in his own words and from his own perspective. His first book was on Vishwamitra, the legendary Brahmarshi who born to a Kshatriya. You can read our unbiased views and reviews for the same, as well as you can listen to the same. I will put the links in the description below. Continuing his quest to explore mythology in a way that it can appeal the current generation and infusing his scientific point of view into the content, he decided to take a look at the life of Ram, the son of Yamadagni or Jamadagni and Renuka, who is better known as Parshuram, due to his possession of his legendary primary weapon. On a side note, when we wrote the book review on our website, we have initially planned to publish it on a specific day, but then what could have been a better day than the Parshuram Jayanti, the birthday of Parshuram, to publish the same. And fortunately, we were able to manage the dates. Let us take a look at the book, The Legend of Parshuram. The cover page of a book plays a vital role in creating the first impression of the same. So let us take a look at the cover page of the book. A clean-shaven, well-built sage performing his tapasya with the snow-clad mountains in the background and his legendary weapon Parshu in different shape than the most famous in front, and the moon above his face will undoubtedly remind you of Lord Shiva. Parshuram belongs to the lineage of Brahma, considered as an avatar of Vishnu and a form of Shiva, so actually representing the whole divine trinity. The cover page in this way actually is effective. However, the clean-shaven face of the sage somehow doesn't go in sync with the rest of the stuff, according to me. Overall, a cover page that is impressive and contain many symbols but could have been a little better. The book starts with the references given in Vishwamitra, the man who dared to challenge the gods, by Dr. Vineet Agarwal. It is worth to note that the book is complete in itself, so if you haven't read that book yet, you can still go ahead and enjoy this book without any issues. With the events that led Ruchik again into isolation and doing the ultimate worship to the god, Satyavati got the responsibility to raise the kids, Vishwarath, her brother, and Yamadagni, her son. Eventually, Vishwarath became the warrior he was trained to be, and Yamadagni was transformed into a learned man. Time passed by and Vishwarath had gone to abode as his destiny took him, and he became Brahmarshi Vishwamitra. Yamadagni, or Yam as he was fondly called, was married to equally intelligent Renuka. Prince Arjun, a brave warrior from Nabi Varsh, is destined to become the first emperor of the entire Navi Varsh and beyond. His rise was a result of his sole intentions of spreading the life of Dharma to the entire civilization. Of course, for a way of living to become the reality for every human, the other ways of living has to decline. Obviously, it leads to clashes between civilizations and various tribes. Arjun's marriage was a calculated move planned by his parents in order to make the Nabi Varsh a safe place for noble humans who follow the path of Dharma. The action eventually leads to the consequences which made him invincible warrior. At the same time, the seeds of the adverse events are rooted as well. How and why? What role Ravan, the rising king of Asura tribe, had to play in the rise and fall of various characters from that time? How Ram, the son of Yama and Renuka, became Parshuram? And how did something unprecedented and not repeated till date happened? Well, you need to read the book in order to get the answers to all these and many more questions. Do you love reading mythology retold? If the answer is yes, then you will find this book a delight to read without a doubt. All the characters of this book are given enough space and time to grow into themselves. The book contains a lot more than the incidents happened in Parshuram's life. From the roots of the legend till his enormous act to retire to isolation are all explored in linear yet interesting manner. In most of the stories, we see the rise of the protagonist explored quite effectively. We cannot say the same for the antagonist though. This book, in that sense, has devoted enough time to the character of Arjun. Various shades of his character, which was white and then transformed into black by passing through many shades of grey, are elaborated nicely. The way all the characters of this book follows their path of karma and dharma will fascinate you. There is no discrimination between the positive and the negative characters in terms of exploration. Of course, the characters of Ruchik, Satyavati, Yamadagni, Renuka and Ram are the strongest of them, along with that of Ravan, Karkotak and others. Telling more about all the characters will lead to spoilers, which I don't want. The most talked incident of Parshuram's life could have been explored in better and detailed way. However, it is written in thrilling way. The author is good at exploring war scenes, and some of the scenes will don't leave your memory even after you complete reading the book. Same we can say about the way the nature is explored. The author belongs to the background of science, and he firmly believes that the Indian mythology is not a mere work of fiction. He tries infusing science at various places to explain the things convincingly, and the mixture is very smooth. Here are some of the interesting lines from the book that talks about relationships, history, dharma, politics, philosophy, and other stuff in an interesting manner. The Supreme Lord is above all relationships, but he can present himself in any form for his devotees. Your father has renounced the world of men and taken sannyas very early, but he returned to honor his unfulfilled commitments. Taking cue from his life, I wish for you to follow the path of karma yoga, since you have a family to take care of. I have blessed him with ability to defeat anyone who is not following dharma, but if he encountered someone who is following all the prescribed rules and still decides to attack, he will certainly be defeated. He realized how important family was, especially in these deserted parts where nature ruled supreme. Humans had managed to modify their environment to the extent that they could survive in almost any corner of the world, but without the benefit of science and technological advances, man was nothing but a weak mammal, poorly equipped to survive his surroundings. To hide one clandestine act, you sometimes have to perform 100 more. In every country or society, there exist a few who are unhappy with the way things are. No matter how far one traveled, one had to come back home at the end of the journey. Well, What is history but the variation of facts by the victorious and self-sympathizing delusions of the defeated? I do not want this chronicle to be written by the court scribes who tend to exaggerate the achievements of the past and downplay its shortcomings. I want it to be a historically accurate manuscript from which future generations can learn their due history. In addition, you would like to read the following in the book, The Definition of Avadhut. Dattatreya's advice about Ram to Yama, Satyavati's way of administration, and more. So, what is the conclusion? Well, overall, a fantastically retold mythological tale with logical approach. The book has good literary attributes and strong characters. The hidden message of the book conveys the importance of destiny and actions and how one needs to walk on his or her own on the path of karma quite effectively. Thinkerview's rating, definitely around 8.5 stars out of 10. So, have you already read the book? Are you planning to read it? What do you think about this book review? Do you find it helpful in deciding whether to go for the book or not? Please do share your genuine remarks via comments below. If you have enjoyed listening to the review, please hit the like button. And do not forget to share it with your friends and other fellows whom you think such reviews interest more. Till we meet with our next podcast, bye-bye, take care, namaskar.